Hello viewers, today we are going to discuss a topic on major components in social casework: person, problem, place and process. Introduction. This lesson explains the main components of social casework. The major purpose of this presentation is to describe the significance of each component in the execution of social casework. It also presents the process and scope of social work research. Objectives. On the completion of this lesson, you would be able to list out the main components of social casework, or 4 P's. Define person, place, problem and process. 3. Understanding the importance of components of social casework. Concepts of social casework. Various definitions of social casework given by different authors, when put together and understood, reveals the fact that social casework is related to the psychosocial treatment of the client in problem and seeks the help of the social caseworker or problem solving agencies. The social casework deal with the adjustment of the individual towards more satisfying human relations. A human being is a complex as well as unique creature, since each individual is made up of the trait gained from his heredity and environment. The problem faced by human beings are also multifarious, and most often they involve many aspects including physical, social, emotional and spiritual. Caseworkers help the individual who seeks assistance from the social casework agency to find solutions among difficulties of any nature, which help a systematic process. Social casework is considered to be a complex, dynamic and evolving phenomenon, as it involves skills, expertise and knowledge of the caseworker. Systematic process guided by commitment, targets and readiness for modification in an environment by client and his significant others. Strict adherence to principles as well as practice ethics in its execution. Components of social casework. The main components of social casework include 4 P's: person, problem, place and process. These components are well defined by Perlman in 1957. As a person with a problem comes to a place where a professional representative helps him by given process. We will discuss about these components in detail. Person. A person in casework is anyone comes to the social service agency for assistance to solve his or her problem, as he she is unable to do it due to certain limitations within self. According to Perlman, a person is a man, woman, child, youth, aged, or anyone who finds himself or is found to be in need of help in some aspects of his social emotional living, whether the need be for the tangible provisions of counsel. As he begins to receive such help, he is called a client. The caseworker attempts to understand the client's needs and responds to the persons in an individualized way according to his or her needs. For understanding the human entity in detail, when seeks assistance to solve problems, it is essential to have knowledge on the dynamic of human behavior includes. Those who comes for social casework services are always under severe frustration and stress. The person's behavior has a purpose and meaning to gain satisfaction, to avoid or dissolve frustrations and to maintain his balance in moment. From the moment of his birth, human beings strive to gratify his felt needs. These needs grow from elementary to complex. The strength and the particular direction of the drive for satisfaction will differ from different people. Human beings strive by his behavior to achieve that internal sense of comfort or satisfaction, which makes him feel in tune with his world, balanced and open to new experiences. Each human being has a number of needs requiring satisfaction. If these needs are not fulfilled, It may result in frustration followed by crisis situation. Problems may be caused due to non-fulfillment of needs or unable to perform his social roles. According to Sigmund Freud, root cause of many problems with which clients seek social casework services are their unfulfilled needs. Making clients aware about their unfulfilled needs is essential for enable them to work towards solving their problems in social casework. Each individual has unique characteristics, but certain needs are common to all people. A need is something that is desirable, useful, or necessary. Human needs are physiological and psychological conditions that an individual must meet to achieve a state of health or well-being. Fulfillment of basic needs make a person happy and satisfied. The physiological and the safety needs constitute the lower order needs. These lower order needs are mainly satisfied externally. The social esteem and the self-actualization needs constitute the higher order needs. These higher order needs are generally satisfied internally, that is, within an individual. Human beings are adaptable and can be understood and helped. These problems can be complex, having physical, social, medical, and emotional aspects in which other family members, friends, colleagues, etc. are also involved. Client and all those linked with a case can be made understood about the importance of behavior or environmental modifications in order to have a favorable atmosphere towards solving problem. The personality of human being is made up of heredity and environment. Each person is the totality of his own heredity and environment. Mann defined personality as the characteristic integration of an individual's structure, modes of behavior, interest, attitudes, capacities, abilities, and aptitudes. To understand human behavior and individual differences, Grace Matthew has given the following propositions. 1. An individual's behavior is conditioned by his or her environment and his or her experiences. Behaviors refers to reaction, feeling, thinking, etc. The conditions and influences surrounding the person constitutes the environment. 2. For human growth and development, it is essential that certain basic needs should be met. Emotional needs are real and they cannot be met or removed through intellectual reasoning. Behavior is purposeful and is in response to the individual's physical and emotional needs. People can be understood only in terms of one's own emotional and intellectual comprehensions. To understand the uniqueness of human behavior and the individual's differences, one needs to understand human beings vis-a-vis his or her social environment and life experiences. A person is a net product of interactions between biological, psychological, and environmental factors. The unique pattern that emerges from this interaction is his personality, which comprises of his capacities and abilities, attitudes, beliefs, and values, feelings and thinking, and his approach or strategies to deal with various situations of life. Having a clear understanding about these enduring characteristics that differentiate a client from others is indeed imperative to carry out casework by a social caseworker, because whether a person's behavior is or is not effective in promoting his well-being depends in large part upon the functioning of his personality structure. Problem. According to Perlman, problem arises from some needs or obstacles or accumulation of frustration or maladjustments, and sometimes all of these together, which threatens or has already attacked the adequacy of the person's living situations or the effectiveness of his efforts to deal with. Paul B. Horton says that a problem is a situation which exists anywhere, anytime, and affects any person. When these hurdles are there, the individuals are becomes conscious of it and tries to find a solution. Sometimes the problem is solved by one's own efforts, or sometimes he needs external help. That external help is given by social worker at individual, group, and community level. Individual problems may arise either because of his unsuitable approach to social situations he encounters in his life, or because of situations demanding something different or more than he possesses. These unresolved problems would affect the social functioning of an individual, which will in turn cause stress to the individual, affects his family and community life, and all the social roles which he or she performs in the society. Social casework methods try to resolve individual problems mainly by restoring, maintaining, or improving the person's social functioning using the knowledge of human communication and relationship skills and the available resources. The caseworker helps an individual in all his aspects of life to enable the person to function adequately and properly in his various social roles. Problem may be caused due to the non-fulfillment of needs or inability to perform social roles, lack of resources, individualistic incapabilities, unpleasant social reactions, and the unfavorable social conditions make human development and functioning difficult and sometimes impossible. According to Sigmund Freud, root cause of many problems with which clients seek social casework services are their unfulfilled needs. Problems can be categorized as follows, Grace Matthews. 1. Problem related to illness and disabilities. Example, disability, fear. Problem due to lack of material resources. Example, bankruptcy, shame. 3. School related problems. Example, learning disability, lack of confidence. 4. Problems related to institutionalization. Example, depression, loneliness. 5. Problems, example, antisocial behavior, running away. 6. Problems of marital discord, example, divorce, depression. 7. Problem situation needs a follow-up services, example, adjustment problem, livelihood. 8. Needs related to rehabilitation of people, example, non-acceptance by family, disability. 9. Clients caught up in social problems like gambling, prostitution, alcoholism, drug addiction, and unmarried motherhood. Example, livelihood, shame. Characteristics of human problems. Perlman. 1. The problems within the purview of social casework are those which vitally affect or are affected by a person's social functioning. 2. Multifaceted and dynamic nature of the client's problems makes necessary the selection by caseworker and client of some part of it as the unit for work. 3. Problems in any part of a human being's living tends to have chain reactions. 4. Any problem with a person encounters has both an objective and a subjective significance. 5. Not only due to the external objectives and internal subjective aspects of the problem coexists, but either one may be the cause of the other. 6. Whatever the nature of the problem the person brings to the social agency, it is always accompanied and often complicated by the problem of being a client. Place. According to Perlman, the place is a social service agency or a social service department of another kind of human welfare agency to which a person comes for help with his problem refers to the institution within which the caseworker practices. Sometimes it is the larger institution that is intended, example, a local authority. And at other times, it is the smaller social work microcosm, example, the psychiatric social work department in a mental hospital. The institution in which caseworkers practice, schools, child guidance clinics, children's department of the hospital and courts and so on have all been established to achieve certain broad social purposes, and her caseworker has a part to play in achieving them. Its purpose is to help individuals within the particular social handicaps which hamper good personal or family living, and with the problems created by faulty person to person, person to groups, or person to situational relationships. The services provided by such agencies can be psychological help, environmental modification, counselling, social support, resource mobilization, or combination of these four clients. Each social agency develops a program by which to meet the particular areas of needs with which it is set out to deal. It depends on factors like money, knowledge, competence and competence of agency staff, the interest, resources available and support of the community. Social casework agencies differ one from the other in a number of ways, but there are three major factors that determine their classifications. 1. Their source of support. Agencies are supported either by public taxation or voluntary contribution. The tax supported agencies are called public agencies, and the agencies that are maintained through the voluntary contributions of individuals or groups are private agencies. 2. Their source of professional authority. Some agencies carry primary and full authority and responsibility for their social welfare functions. Others, because they are part of another human welfare organization, derives their authority and responsibility from the host agency. The former may be called the primary and the later secondary social agencies. 3. Their special functions and areas of concern. Primary agencies, both public and private, may define certain areas of social needs as the particular field in which they give services and in which they develop expertness of knowledge and special problem solving resources. There are, for example, many multi-purpose child welfare agencies, but there are also many agencies specialized only in certain aspects of child welfare, adoption, foster homes, learning disability, addiction, etc. As it becomes impossible for any one human being to know all there is to know about meeting personal and social needs. So, it becomes impossible for any one agency to contain in its program and give in its service all the kind of welfare aid. Agencies, therefore, may develop to meet and to advance knowledge about particular kinds of problems. Process. According to Perlman, the process named social casework is a progressive transaction between the professional helper, the caseworker, and the client. It consists of series of problem-solving operations carried on within a meaningful relationship. The end of this process is contained in its means. It influences the client that he or she develops effectiveness in coping with his or her problem, and or to so influence the problem as to resolve it or reduce its effects. Process in casework means an organized, systematic and step-by-step method of helping people to let them out of trouble. The idea of casework process stems from a natural process in human being, that is, problem-solving process. It is a natural process through which individual continuously try to adjust himself to the environment or adapt the environment to them so as to achieve maximum satisfaction. The casework process is essentially one of problem solving. When persons encounter a problem that defines their coping efforts or that requires for its solution, some means that cannot command that they turn to persons whose perspectives, expertise or resource may be of help. In order to understand what the casework process must include in its problem solving help, according to Perlman, it is the necessary to take stock first of the kind of blockings which occurs in person's normal problem solving efforts. These following six are the most common. 1. A problem cannot be solved if the necessity, tangible means and resources are not available to the person. 2. Sometimes people are unable to solve their problems simply out of ignorance or misapprehension about the facts of the problem or the facts of the existing way of meeting it. 3. A problem is difficult of resolution, which the person who has it is depleted or drained of emotional or physical energies. 4. Some problems arose, high feelings in a person's emotions are so strong that they overpower his reason and defy his conscious control. Sometimes these feelings are realistically called for, and in the case of death of a dear one. 5. The problem may lie within the person, that is, he may have become subject to or victim of emotions that chronically over a long time have governed his thinking and actions. 6. Some people find problems difficult of solution because they have never developed systematic habits or orderly methods of thinking and planning. The intent of the casework process is to engage the person himself both in working on and in coping with the one or several problems that confront him, or to do so by such means as may stand him in good stead as he goes forward in living. All competent problem solving contains three essential operations given below. 1. Study, fact finding. Study is social casework refers to the process of collecting information regarding the client and his problem. The information is mostly collected through the interviews. The first source of the information is the client himself. But when the client is unable to give the information, then the caseworker turns over to the secondary resources, which can be his family, friends, or relatives. The focus of the initial interview is to collect the information about the identification of the client. Example, name, age, gender, marital status, occupation, date of birth, and religion, etc. Current complaints about the client and the view about the complaint, the fact about the problem, previous mental problem, medical history, personality, example, reaction patterns, diseases, sickness, emotional problems, eating, sleeping habits, is behavior, etc. That a complete sketch of the history and the present situation of the client, the strengths and weaknesses, potential and capabilities, that is, his internal and external environments, are made in the study phase of this problem solving process. 2. Diagnosis. Dictionary meaning of diagnosis is the identification of the nature or cause of something, especially a problem or fault. Example, the doctor diagnoses tuberculosis. After a complete and thorough study of the client and his problem, the worker then diagnoses and assesses the problem. How the problem which have been identified by the client and his family are affecting the client or his family. What is the problem and what the client needs to do. The worker finds out the extent of the problem, that is, whether it is an intrapersonal or interpersonal problem. He also tries to find out the major factors operating in this situation. When the assessment is completed, the worker reaches to the actual fact, that is, what is the actual problem and how all of them are looking upon it. Then the worker tells the client and his family or friends that this is the real problem. 3. Treatment. Implementation of conclusions as to what and how of action upon the problem. Dictionary meaning of treatment is the techniques or actions customarily applied in a specified situation. Now that we have completed the study and we also have found the actual problem, there is a need of the client to solve this problem. The worker in this phase of the process of social casework find out different solutions of the problem and provides the alternative way to the client. On the basis of the study and assessment, the caseworker makes an action plan for the client. The focus of the plan is to enable the client himself to solve the problem, to feel the actual problem, to think about it and choose an alternative or solution for it. Summary. The main components of the social casework includes 4 P's: person, problem, place and process. If a mother comes to a child guidance clinic, as she is not able to manage her learning disabled son, mother is a person. Her inability to manage her learning disabled child and associated negative feelings and emotions like depression, anxiety, shame, fear, etc. are the problems. Child guidance clinic is the place, and process includes problem solving methods like study, diagnosis and intervention, counselling, psychotherapy, special training to teach learning disabled children, etc. done by the social caseworker of the child guidance clinic. In social casework, each and every component is equally important, as it is necessary that the caseworker must grasp the nature of the person, client, nature of the problem and the nature of the place without containing the problem solving means.